Space News is brought to you by General Motors of Canada and all of its divisions.
Every hour of every day, we are gradually using up our natural resources to light our homes and fuel our cars. But a team of scientists have developed a green alternative, which will be the fuel of the future.
Now, the type of plant that these scientists are using are not the kind that you could keep at home. They're called microscopic green algae.
What these algae are doing, they're taking water and transferring it into carbon. Water is H2O, as you know. It has hydrogen attached to oxygen. We have to take the hydrogen off of the oxygen and stick it onto carbon. So they're making carbon-hydrogen bonds. If they're stressed, and that's what the trick of these researchers, they take away their sulfur, and that forces the bacteria to start eating their carbon-hydrogen bonds. That's their source of their fuel. When they do that, they bubble hydrogen out of the water. So effectively, they've taken sunlight, water, they've made carbon-hydrogen bonds, hydrocarbons, and then they start burning them, but they give off hydrogen in that case. So if we collect the hydrogen, you could then use that as a fuel.
So exactly when can we expect the algae to go from the pond to the fuel pump? Well, there's still a few details that need to be worked out.
For our own cars, it's a problem because it's expensive to pressurize and refrigerate hydrogen to store for long distances. But 2 liters of hydrogen would, at the moment, would only take you down the block. It wouldn't even take you around the block, I don't think. So that it has, when it's just in a gas form, if it's pressurized, you could go further, obviously. Not as far as 2 liters of gasoline, but for the same volume, but a significant distance. And of course, the benefit is that there's just water produced coming out your exhaust pipe as opposed to carbon dioxide.